Welcome to episode 3 of Classroom Pizza. I'm your teacher, Justin, and it's time for class. Last week on Classroom Pizza, we covered the entirety of pizza making in 18 minutes. So we're done. Classroom Pizza's over. See ya. I'm just kidding. That was only the beginning. That was just our launch pad, our pizza foundation. Now, moving forward, we can become pizza scientists. Every week, we're going to learn a new tip, trick, skill, or topic and use that to tweak our recipe in some way. Or come up with an entirely different recipe altogether. Let's get started this week talking about baker's percentages. This is a pretty simple concept. Next to each ingredient, you're going to see a little percentage sign, and it's going to tell you how much of an ingredient is being used as it compares to the amount of flour in that recipe. So let's say we have 100 grams of flour and 70 grams of water, that would be 70%. So a quick guide to finding this, math time. Start by taking the weight of the ingredient in question, let's say 15 grams of salt, and dividing it by the amount of flour we're using. So if we're using 330 grams of flour, that's how many grams we used in our first pizza dough recipe. We would take 15 grams of salt divided by 330 grams of flour and get our final answer of 0.045. And remember, converting a decimal to percent is just as easy as moving the decimal two places to the right. So that's 4.5%. Now this is where the trial and error, and this is where the majority of your pizza journey is going to take place. Going one ingredient at a time and upping or lowering the percentages to figure out, one, what effect does that have on my dough? And two, do I like it? That's the key, and that's why we only change one ingredient at a time, so that we know, okay, today we're not doing honey. Tomorrow we are doing honey. What's the difference between the two, and do I like it, and how does it affect my dough? Let's review last week's recipe. We made two 12-inch dough balls using 330 grams of flour, 220 grams of water, which is about 67%. We used 10 grams of fine sea salt, about 3%. Then we used 15 grams of both olive oil and honey, which is around 4.5%. And lastly, we used about a sixth of a teaspoon of instant yeast, which is less than a percent. This week, we're going to tweak our recipe so that we are making a single individual 12-inch dough ball. Today, the only thing we are changing is our percentage of honey. Honey is a sweetening agent, but it has a few other roles as well. Most of the time, you'll see chefs using sugar if they use any kind of sweetening agent at all. Personally, I have found that honey has yielded the best results for me. True Neapolitan style pizza doesn't use anything like that. So this recipe is really more of a New York style pizza. Quick science lesson. What's happening in our dough with all of these ingredients? Well, the yeast is eating the starch that's found in the flour. As it eats those sugars, it releases carbon dioxide. That's what causes the dough to rise. It's the buildup of carbon dioxide, but it has nowhere to go, because this gluten network we formed when we kneaded the dough is trapping it in. So there's more carbon dioxide coming, but there's nowhere for it to go. By adding sugar or honey, we're just giving the yeast more food to eat. The more that it eats, the more that dough rises. This is a trick we can use when we have shorter fermentation times. We want to give the yeast as much food as we can so that it creates much more carbon dioxide and makes our dough rise faster. By giving it more sugar or more honey, we're giving it more food to eat over a smaller window of time. The second reason we add honey is because it helps with browning the pizza when we use a home oven. There's a fancy term for this, but we won't go into that today. So that we can see the difference that honey is making in our dough, we're going to make two identical doughs today, except for one thing, the amount of honey. In the first dough, we're going to use 0% honey. And in the second, we're going to jump our normal amount of honey we used last week, 4.5%, all the way up to 10%. Other than that, the process is going to be the exact same with the exact same ingredients. Let's make a montage. We'll be right back. doughs are ready, so let's get them assembled and into the oven. All right, so here we have our no honey dough, and you can tell, look at the crust, it's not brown at all, whereas our honey dough with a lot more browning on the edges here, this looks just barely like anything happened to it. Today, we learned about baker's percentages and how we can start experimenting at home by playing with these percentages. Then we talked about different sweetening agents and the effect that they have on our dough. Your homework this week is to experiment with your sugar levels. Try using more or less honey. Try using table sugar. Try using another sweetening agent and see if you can tell a difference. Then, wherever you watched, come back and leave a comment and let me know how it went. So that'll do it for episode 3. I'm your teacher, Justin, and as always, thanks for coming to class.